This year for Halloween, I decided to go as the Phantom of the Opera. I decided to make my costume, and also, too, I decided to make my mask. You can go out to the store and actually buy a half mask that you can get at Walmart or Party City. It's made out of plastic. It's about $3.99, which isn't bad. But the only problem with that is I've had one before, and I've had to trim the eyes a little because they were digging into, like, right here in my eyes. And also, too, I had to sand out the nose because it was actually starting to dig in my nose and was very irritating. And I can only wear it for, like, 10, 15, 20 minutes at a time before it really started irritating. The nice thing about being able to make the mask is it will actually be molded more to my face, so it will sit more comfortably, and also too, I'll be able to add details or take away details that I see fit, and also too, I want to make a full face mask instead of just the half face, because in the original story and also too in some of the other movie interpretations, he actually does have a full face that is disfigured instead of just half. And that is something that I always found interesting. So in my interpretation, he does wear the full face because I will be doing makeup for a full facial disfiguration. The main thing that you want to get is the plaster wraps, because this is what we're actually making the mask out of. You're also going to need something to sand the mask with. Scissors. Also, too, I'm going to use a white gloss paint for the final touches on the mask. You're also going to need some type of plaster, like Plaster of Paris or this pottery plaster that I'm using. What this is going to do is use to fill in any gaps and unevenness. You're going to need some kind of strap, so this way you can actually strap the mask to your face. You're also going to need some type of glue. I recommend glue that actually works with ceramics. What you're going to do with the glue is actually glue the straps to the mask, so this way you can strap the mask to your face. You're also going to need something to pour the warm water in that you're going to be dipping the plaster bandages in. I'm just using this 5-quarts mix and measure. You don't have to use anything this big. A normal bowl out of the kitchen will work fine, because all you're doing with it is just dipping in the plaster bandages into the warm water, then applying it to your face. Another item you're going to need, petroleum jelly. And we all know what that's for.
My mind's telling me no! But my body's telling me yes. Baby, I don't want to hurt nobody, but there is something that I must confess
to you.
I don't see nothing wrong.
No, that's not what that's for. What the petroleum jelly's for is you put it on your face, and it helps create a barrier between your face and the plaster that's in the bandages. So this way, the plaster doesn't irritate your skin, doesn't cause rashes, pull out any facial hair that you might have, any hair in your eyebrows or up here. It's not for that. If you're going to do that, I recommend personal lubricant. It's a lot easier, and it doesn't make your junk feel like it's got, like, goop all over it for the rest of the day. Dummy. One thing you say you're going to want to do in preparation is actually take your bandage strips and cut it into about 6 inches long and about 2 inches wide, so this way when you go to apply it to your face, you don't have like these huge wads on your face, and it's actually a little bit more easier to work with. Now that we have the plaster bandages cut into strips, what I'm going to do now is prep my face by washing it and shaving any facial hair, so this way I get a little bit of a smoother texture on the actual mask, and it doesn't have like any bumps or ridges or might accidentally kind of get tangled up in my facial hair. So, I'm going to prep my face, and here we go. Now that I applied the Vaseline on my face, I'm pretty sure it probably has a nice little shine to it. I already have my station set up. As you can see, I have my strips and my warm water. And what I'm going to do now is take the strips. You're going to take your plaster strap, take your two fingers acting like they're scissors, hold it just like so, and you're actually going to dunk it in the water, and when you pull it out of the water, you're going to pull it through your two fingers, and what this is going to do, this is going to wring out any excess water, and also too, it's going to help smear the plaster more into the bandage, so this way, instead of it having the holes as seen here, it's actually going to be one solid piece, and then we're going to apply it to our face. And I'm just going to apply it to my face.
Thank you.
now that I made the mask, yeah, and I sound funny, to take it off, all you're going to do is just kind of work your face. Careful. You take it off because it's still gonna be a little tender in some areas. And you see with the petroleum jelly, I still got a little bit of the residue on my face, but it did cause the mask to actually come off. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna let it air dry for 24 hours. There's also instructions to where you can put it in the oven or in the microwave, but I'm just going to let mine air dry for the 24 hours. And then after it dries, I'm going to recheck it when I can actually see a little bit better to see if there's any touch-ups or anything I need to do before I do any sanding. So we're going to let the mask dry, then it's touch-ups and sanding. So this is the mask after it's dried and after I did some light sanding. A tip, don't sand too hard. I had to remake the mask because I've sanded too much off and you can start seeing the bandages stick through. One thing I did discover later on was you take the plaster of Paris and you kind of just do a small thin coat of the plaster of Paris and it helps fill in the gaps and helps recover the bandages. The mask, once it is fully painted, I did about 3 coats of the gloss white on it. I also took a gray color and just did like a very light coat just to kind of give it some shadowing and highlights, so this way it just brings out the skull a little bit more. And then as you can see here, I glued the strap on the inside of the mask so this way I can strap it to my forehead. And here's the mask final completion with the straps on and strapped to my face. The nice thing about the straps is it actually, where it is strapped, I just went ahead and strapped everything right up in here, so it does kind of give it a little bit of a pad, so it's not exactly irritating my face, and it doesn't hold the mask exactly onto my face, so this way when I wear the makeup and stuff, it's not actually going to keep rubbing off into the mask. One thing I will suggest if you do wear makeup underneath the mask is actually put baby powder inside the mask, so this way when the makeup touches it, it's not going to stick to the mask. Thank you for watching the video, and I hope you enjoyed it. Not only did I decide to make my costume, I also decided to make my mask. The main reason behind... I'm in the wrong shirt. Here for Halloween, I decided to go as the Phantom of the Opera. I decided to make my costume, and also, too, I decided to make my mask. You can go out to the store and actually buy a half mask that you can get at Walmart or Party City. It's made of plastic. It's about $3.99, which isn't bad. But the only problem with that is I've had one before and I've had to trim the eyes a little because they were digging into like right here in my eyes. And also too, I had to sand out the nose because it was actually starting to dig in my nose and was very irritating. And I can only wear it for like 10, 15, 20 minutes at a time before it really started irritating. The nice thing about being able to make the mask is it will actually be molded more to my face, so it will sit more comfortably, and also too, I'll be able to add details or take away details that I see fit, and also too, I want to make a full face mask.